Cause if you're ready to fetch, just call my name. Ready to party, call my name. Carnival, yes, it's coming back again.
Hey, it's 89.9 Qute FM. You're vibing with your girl Joyce Kahuna, and let me tell you this, I told you I was going to have some guests in the air chair today, and I have got them there. Listen, folks, some big things about to go on, a lot of events going on, not only this weekend, this month, but also in the month of August. So let me do this. I've got a slew of folks that I want to welcome to the air chair, but before I officially do that, this young man I want to welcome, his name is John. He is the co-lead for the Caribbean Soccer Night, which is a big event coming up this weekend. But first of all, John, welcome to the air chair. Now, you picked that jam. That was Aaron Duncan, and the jam is called Forever. Tell our listeners why you picked that jam, and then let's talk about this big event coming up this weekend.
Yes, Joyce, thanks for having me. And the reason why I chose Aaron Duncan Forever is because it's carnival season / celebration season, and the song is fitting, so I would expect, because it has this vibrant energy, the energy should translate for the remainder of the coming celebration season. So definitely come out and celebrate this August, well, July 1st, come out July 8th at Soccer Night, which is coming up, and then carry over into August.
All right. So that's what's up. So listen, folks, we're going to talk to John some more, but let me tell you who else is hanging out with us, because you don't want to miss this. All right. Not only do I have John representing the Hartford Athletic League and the big event coming up this coming Saturday, I've also got hanging out in the air chair, I've got Tiara. She's representing the West Indian Social Club as well. I have got also Marcia representing a Big Taste. You know, the Big Taste that comes up, the taste of the Caribbean and Jerk Festival. She is in the air chair. And I've also got Natasha hanging out with a big celebration coming up. So with that said, so you've got kind of a precursor of who you are riding with right now on 89.9 Qute FM. But let's go back to John. Now, John, you're talking about a big event, right? Where a number of athletes come together. So first of all, is it soccer or is it football? Because when we start talking about this Caribbean thing, what do we call it?
Okay, just to correct folks out there, we are in America, so we're going with soccer, folks. Sorry to burst your bubble. It's soccer this year, and it's going to be soccer next year, and it's probably going to be the soccer after that. So it's soccer, folks.
Now, listen, so in all our Caribbean listeners here on 89.9 Qute FM, they're yelling at the radio. They're saying, football, man, come on, it's football. So tell our listeners about this soccer, this football that's going down this Saturday, right, July 8th. Where, what time, and what is the significance of the event? Because I know the players on the Hartford Athletic League, they represent a number of islands, whether it's Haiti, Jamaica, Trinidad. But tell them what they can expect for this coming Saturday.
So this Saturday, you can expect first the tailgate party, which is running from 4 to 6:30 p.m., essentially the pregame party, you should call it. And that, you'll have a DJ from Busy Radio skip in, and then you will have free food until it runs out. That is, so make sure you come early. And after that, the game will kick off at 7 p.m., where you'll see Hartford Athletics go up against the San Diego, a team from San Diego. And so be present for that. It's going to be a fun, energetic environment. So bring your vuvuzela, bring your colors, wear your colors, I should say. Just come out just to enjoy a night of soccer. And halftime, we're going to have the flag raising ceremony, which representation from Trinidad and Tobago, Jamaica, Haiti, St. Vincent, and the Grenadines will be on the field. I was going to say court, but it's going to the field in this case. Just be there in representation. And the game will kick off after that. We'll have some kids running through the tunnel, high-fiving the players, so you don't want to miss that as well. So that's essentially the gist of Caribbean Soccer Night. And here's the big kicker here, folks. Big kicker, did you get that? It's a great cause to benefit local youth soccer team, one of which Hartford Lions Soccer Academy, HBDL, and we're in Bloomfield, and also we're touching Windsor next year. So folks, come out and support. Get your fundraiser tickets now.
And that's what's up. So listen, folks, if you're just joining us here on 89.9 Qute FM, we're talking about a big event that's going down not only this Saturday, but a number of events coming up. Right now, we're talking about the Hartford Athletic League. And how great is that for Connecticut to have a professional soccer league right here where they can work with young people, right, as a feeder organization. So this is a big event on Saturday. It's a fundraiser and it's going to be a good time. And where is the location, John, before we jump into our next participant?
It is at the Trinity Health Stadium, formerly Dillon Stadium, downtown Hartford. Just Google Trinity Health Stadium or Dillon Stadium. You'll find it very quickly.
All right, there it is. And so as we're talking to our participants, some are representing the West Indian Social Club, and you are too, John. There's another great program that does happen there at the West Indian Social Club. It's Toastmasters. Talk quickly about that before we jump into Tiara to talk a little bit more about some of the events at the West Indian Social Club.
All right, Joyce, I'm glad to talk about Toastmaster because two things. One, Toastmaster this year, in my level four of Toastmaster, this incorporates project management. And part of this project management project is executing Caribbean Soccer Night, folks. So here you have a leadership development organization which you can work on project that you can apply straight in community organization or business organization, whatever organizations that are out there, you can apply it in line, in parallel, however you want to say it. But these are applicable skills across the board. So catch Toastmasters or Toastmasters in general is a way for to develop your leadership skills and in the change your communication skills as well.
And that's what's up. So listen, folks, if you just tune in to 89.9 Qute FM and you talk about Toastmasters, those ums and ahs and huh and all of those fillers, you can work those out right there at the West Indian Social Club. Quickly, when do you all meet and can you do that via Zoom as well?
Yes, so we are a hybrid club, which means we meet both in person and online. So we meet on the second and fourth Tuesdays of the month. We're in a redevelopment stage, so we'd love to have you if you're interested in leadership development and also communication development. So catch those Master, second and fourth Tuesdays. Hope to see you there, West Indian Social Club.
All right, big things are going on. And so, John, thank you for joining us. Now we're going to jump into Tiara. Tiara's joining us, also representing the West Indian Social Club. And so when you talk about whether it's Toastmasters, whether it's getting out, supporting the kids, going to the fundraiser to enjoy some good soccer, all of this helps our mental health. And Tiara is the health coordinator for the West Indian Social Club. So, Tiara, welcome to the air chair here at 89.9. Nice to have you.
Thank you for having me. I really appreciate it.
And tell us a little bit about what is coming up that's going to help our mental health, because this whole pandemic is still going on. We've been in isolation and we're slowly coming out. So tell us a little bit about what you've got going on as it relates to the West Indian Social Club.
Definitely. Thank you so much. So on July 16th, we are going to have our mental health and wellness series. The topic for this month is social isolation and loneliness. So I know that a lot of us experienced a lot of that, especially during COVID, and some of us are still trying to get readjusted to being social and being in the outside world. And so this series is going to help us to learn how to cope and how to get out of that familiarity of being isolated. It talks about the risks and how it can impact your life, but it also gives you an opportunity to learn the mechanisms to use in order to live a fulfilling life and to get back out there and to have that confidence to put yourself out there. We also typically have an activity that goes with it. So last series we had art as therapy or therapeutic art, where we learned how to paint. We've had yoga. We've also had journaling. This month we're going to have theater. So the art of theater is learning how to live truthfully through imaginary circumstances. So this month we'll have an opportunity to learn how to get mental clarity, how to ground ourselves, but also how to loosen our body to reignite our imagination, get back to that childlike state so we can really enjoy life again and have that peace of mind, and also, you know, put on a different character and escape reality. So it should be a really, really, really fun event on July 16th. It is a hybrid event, so if you'd like to join us in person, it'll be at the West Indian Social Club at Hartford at 3340 Main Street in Hartford, Connecticut, or you could join us on Zoom. There is an Eventbrite if you want to look that up, so all the information will be there as well. And it is 3 p.m. to 5 p.m.
Oh, that's perfect. And thank you for that, Tiara. And so if folks wanted to jump on Eventbrite, what will they Google? What should they Google as we're talking with Tiara from the West Indian Social Club, talking about mental health and wellness and a free event coming up that we all can participate in? What should they Google to find more about that on Eventbrite?
They should Google the West Indian Social Club Mental Health and Wellness Series.
All right, there it is. So we got to keep this train moving, folks. Let me tell you, you're getting a lot of information on today. I got a number of folks hanging out in the air chair, and let's move right on to Marcia. Marcia is ready to get her groove on, as we all are, with the taste of, wait, let me not steal your fire. Marcia, welcome to the show. And tell the folks what is about to go on as it relates to your big event that you're representing for. I can't even give the title, because then I'm going to give away the event. Go right ahead.
It is, yes. Well, thank you so much, first of all, for having me on your program. It's a great honor. And I'd like to say hello to Hartford and the surrounding areas. And thank you so much for supporting the Taste of the Caribbean and Jerk Festival. And we will be presenting our 18th year this year, and I'm overexcited. I can't wait to showcase all of the new things that will be happening. We have three headliners this year, the first being Michael Rose, Grammy nominated and winner, Michael Rose from Black Uhuru. He's from Jamaica, and he will be on board. We have Jabez, and he's a great gospel artist that is returning again this year to the Taste of the Caribbean and Jerk Festival. We're having also from Trinidad and Tobago, as we like to try to incorporate as many of the islands as possible. We're going to be having Crazy, and he's going to come and jump up and go back through all of the various songs that he's made popular throughout the year. So we're looking forward to him. But we haven't stopped there. We are also having Jazz Shelby, and he is from Haiti. So Haiti will be in the house, and we will still have our normal steel bands and local bands. We'll have In a Higher Heights, the backing band for Michael Rose, and we'll have Profile Band. And Profile Band is a great band that actually was at our Jazz Fusion this year, and they'll be coming back on the plaza. So I want to say the date. I don't want to, you know, keep going. I want to make sure that you know the date. Again, it's Saturday, August the 5th. We kick off at 1 o'clock, and we go straight through till 9 p.m. The greatest thing about our festival is it's free, free, free. There's no cost to you. It's open to the family. It's a family-friendly event. Not only do we have the artists, we have so many restaurants that will be represented on the plaza, showcasing Caribbean food. Of course, Jerk will be at the center, but we'll have, you know, our chicken, fish, vegetables. I know there's vegetarian, vegan delicacies that will be there also. So you'll have a little bit of everything. You will have a taste of the Caribbean in music. You will have the taste of the Caribbean in cultural items. So we will have vendors there as well. We always incorporate our children. The Children's Village will again be located over at the Science Center, which is on the same plaza right there connecting to the riverfront. You don't have to go far. It's going to be free. We have face painting there for the children. We'll have arts and crafts. I believe this year, based on the Knox Foundation giving us a small grant, we'll teach them about gardening.
Yes.
You know, this is so much. I could probably take over the entire program, but
I know you could, Marcia. Oh my goodness. And all of the food sounds so good at the Taste of the Caribbean Jerk Festival. And I hear, listeners, that is all calorie free. So mark your calendar. August 5th and come on out and have a good time. And Marcia, where does that take place as we get ready to jump into Natasha? Because Natasha's got quite a bit of information she needs to share. But where's the location for the Taste of Caribbean Jerk Fest?
We're at the Riverfront Plaza in downtown Hartford. So it's in a central location, easy access. But just in case you didn't get all of that information, the best way to find out about it is to go to our website. Go to tastect.org. That's tastect.org. All the information is there. The location is there. The artist is there. We'll have the schedule up there.
All of the good stuff, they can get it right there at that website. That's what's up.
And if you're looking for hotel information, that
we're gonna get it all on the website, Marcia. We can't steal Natasha's fire. You see what happened when you start talking about the taste and the jerk and the this and the that. Well, listen, we appreciate you, but now I gotta move right into Natasha. Natasha is hanging out in the air chair representing the West Indian Social Club Independence Celebration. Oh, all the islands getting ready to come together to wave the flag in the air. Natasha, take it away. Welcome to the air chair.
Well, thank you so much for having me, Joyce. I'm Natasha, as Joyce mentioned, and I'm actually representing the West Indian Independence Celebration Committee. I am, however, going to give you a rundown of all the events that will be taking place at the West Indian Social Club, or at least the highlights of the events that will be taking place. First and foremost, after the taste on the Saturday, we're going to have West Indian Celebration Day at the Yard Goat Stadium. So please do join us for that in downtown Hartford. Following that, we have St. Lucia Nights at the club. That's the Monday. Then we have Jamaica Night on the Tuesday, Guyanese Night on the Wednesday, African American Night the Thursday, and then we have the big All Island Night on the Friday. Now, after Friday, we want you guys to go home early so you can get up and come out for the parade the next day, which is Saturday, August 12th. The parade takes place, or it starts from the corner of North Main Street and Albany Avenue in downtown Hartford, and it marches from there right into Bushnell Park. Now in Bushnell Park, we will have the Carnival Village, and there we will have the judging for the parade participants, as well as some entertainment that will be provided from local artists. In addition to the judging at the Carnival Village, we will make presentations to this year's Grand Marshals. And then after the Carnival Village, you definitely want to join us at the concert, which starts at 3 p.m. This year's headliners are Mad Cobra, QQ, and we have from St. Lucia Moto. He'll be bringing all the soca vibes, all the island vibes into Bushnell Park this year. In addition to those artists, we have a number of artists. We have an Afrobeat artist this year. His name is Nana NYC, and he'll be performing at the concert in downtown Hartford. In addition, we have Aisha Nova, Deja.
Oh my goodness,
so Marissa, and a whole bunch of other people, and it's all hosted by the Burger Man, coming straight to you live and direct from Jamaica, from Mellow FM in Jamaica. He'll be coming to host the event this year, like he did again. So get ready to laugh. And speaking of laughing, we also have two comedians that's on the program this year. So we have Stephen the Boy and Lemon. So once again, that's Saturday, August 12th. It's at the Bushnell Park in downtown Hartford. If you're looking for more information, do find us on Facebook and also on Instagram at WIIC Hartford, as well as look us up on the internet at WIIChartford.org.
That's
my rundown.
Goodness, so much information from the West Indian Independence Celebration. All right, we got to make sure we get that right. And listen, if you come on out and hang out Friday night, just stay up. Don't even go to bed and then come on out to the parade. Just make sure you shower up a little bit. But you know how it all goes down. The whole week mashes together from Jamaica to St. Lucia to Guyana to all of that. We all have a wonderful time. And so listen, folks, I really appreciate you hanging out with us on 89.9 Qute FM. We don't have a lot of time left. Matter of fact, we got about about a little less than a minute left. So you got any quick shout outs? And then I'm going to send it right back to John to take it away to send our listeners a jam to ride home with, right? Because we got to jump back into some more music. But listen, a lot of celebrations coming up from this weekend to August, the first Saturday of August, and then straight from there on, wonderful hosts coming in to take care of those events. So listen, from the West Indian Social Club, from the West Indian Celebration Committee, from the Hartford Athletics League, thank you all for doing what you do. Quick shout outs, and then John, tell us what we're going to send our listeners to for their ride home.
Well, I would love to shout out Claudette Graham. She's the Director of Education at the West Indian Social Club. She's the one who heads the mental health and wellness series and makes it all happen. So
all
shout
right.
out to her.
Shout out, quickly.
I would like to shout out the West Indian Celebration Committee and thank you so much for all the sacrifices and hard work that's going into the planning of this year's event. And people, please get your flags ready. Get your flags ready. We want to see all the flags represented in Bushnell Park this year.
There it is. Take it away.
And I would like to also shout out the committee, because without the committee, there would be no taste, especially our president, Ms. Melinda DeBetham, and our executive director, Mr. Leslie Perry. And
right.
I just want to see everyone out there. We need volunteers. Hit us up.
There it is. John, take it away. What are we sending our listeners home with and what you got?
All right, folks.
30 seconds. I'm going to shout
you out, the people. Definitely come out and support all the events coming up. And I'm going to send you out with We Are One, Ole Ola.
All right.
Etc. It's a great, excited song to celebrate the events coming up in soccer.
Soccer. Thank you, folks. Thank you for hanging out with 89.9 Qute FM. And come on out for each and every celebration. See you later.
Thank you, Joyce. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Joyce.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good night.